Well, hello everybody, welcome to Baku for our final of the day. We are outside on the shotgun range for the first time, and awaiting us is the women's skeet final. It is still pretty warm out here at the moment, still around the 30 degree mark, and the sun away to our left hand side, shadows lengthening. But we are ready to go. Six athletes have made it, three from the United States. Who will be crowned world champion? We'll find out very shortly. Skeet women's final. We've got a good crowd in. A lot of locals have arrived. They are very enthusiastic. We're cheering the test fires, don't you know? And why not? This is the wonderful complex to the right, the indoor activities to the left of your picture, the shotgun arena and the finals range. It's 32. There you are. My watch said 31, but there's so many people here, my Wi-Fi is sort of ground to a halt, so I'll take 32. There was a wind gusting from right to left as you look out on the range, which might make life a little difficult. Nice Brazil t-shirts. I wonder if they're doing trades. Can't mistake that gold, can you? And the badge as well. No Brazilians in our final six. There are three Americans, a Slovakian, a Greek, and Claveto Chadid from Chile. Those are the six that have made it through qualification. Martina Bortolomei just missing out in the shoot-off alongside Sena Can of Turkey. The good news is, though, that both the Italian and the Turkish athlete we will see again. Well, six are now being introduced to the crowd. This is Danka Bartikova, the world number two, the 38-year-old. I saw her inside, and she's wandering around, obviously away from one of her qualification rounds. I said, "How you getting on?" She said, "Yeah, it's okay." Turns out she qualified first. Emma Lula Tsouraki from Greece, a junior mixed team world championship bronze, 22 years of age. Very confident young woman, I think it's fair to say. And then the first of our three Americans. This is Austin Smith. Just 22 years of age as well. Was just outside the final in Tokyo. Has a couple of golds in world championships in team and mixed team in 22 in Osijek and 2019 as well. Athlete number four, also for the United States. This is Dania Vizzi, world number seven, veteran at 28. Jay Waldron is a very relaxed man, the main American coach. He has the team in as well. Lance is there. And they'll all be sitting there, three coaches proudly. Not sure who will be coaching who, technically. Sam Simonton is our last American, the 23-year-old. Has a team gold in the World Championships last year in Osijek and a bronze as well. All smiles, the Americans, qualifying third, fourth and fifth. Smith and Vizzi having to shoot off against each other for the rights to third and fourth. And of course, Simonton and Claveto Chadid, who has just arrived, were one of a four-way shoot-off on 121 in qualification. The 33-year-old, apart from Bartikova, the only 30-year-old in the championship. Eighth in London, of course, close but not close enough. And her best in the World Championship, fifth in Granada. I do remember in charge, Panagiotis Thermalidis is from Greece. He'll keep an eye on proceedings. Our referee in charge is from Thailand, Dui Simanon. She has the air defenders. She will be watching these athletes to make sure this goes well. This is the start list. Remember that it is important in shotgun, certainly in Skeet in this format that you qualify well, because it will give you an advantage if, when we have to lose an athlete, some athletes are level on target's hit. And let me just go through how this is going to work, because it has changed in the last few months. Six in the final, of course, 20 targets. So that's twice around station three, four, and five. And the first person leaves. Another 10 targets, second person. Another 10 target, third. Further 10 targets, bronze is decided. And then another 10 targets decide gold and silver. The only time we will shoot off is when gold and silver is at stake. The rest of the time, we will look at the bib number. If you have qualified above the other person, then you will stay in the competition. It's as simple as that. Luciana Rossi has been at all the finals, or majority of the finals, indoors, but his passion, his background, his shotgun. We've got a lot of, I think, some schools and colleges in. They're cheering absolutely everything. We are underway. Artakova takes the one from the high house. Four for her to get us underway. Number two from Tanava, looking in decent nick. How about Katsaraki? Greason. Cyprus, they love their sports shooting. They would love, there's quite a few in the stands who would love to cheer this youngster on. World Cup silver at Rabat earlier this year. Bit cooler in Rabat in January, you know. There's a bit of rain around as well in that shotgun World Cup. Well, no greens, no reds. Can Austin Smith keep that going? It's a great atmosphere here. They've really done a great job, the organizers. Good atmosphere. And it looks wonderful, this finals range. A little smile from the first of the Americans. Now, Dania Vizzi. World champion in Moscow, all the way back in 2017. Looking in very good nick indeed. Goodness me, is this going to be a tight one? 60 targets to be shot if you're going to be gold or silver. 20 if you're going to be in sixth place. This is excellent stuff, really is. What can Sam Simonton do? If you join us for the first time, it's great to have your company. We'll go through how this works. They'll go around three stations. They use a lot more in qualification. And as you have probably already worked out, we have two doubles. The second one, the reverse of the first one. And the tricky one, generally, is the one, the last one they shoot, the one out of the high house. The angle just a little trickier. But so far, so good. Pressure then perhaps on Francisca Claveto Jadid of Chile. She's been there or thereabouts, but her best world championship result was fifth in Granada in 2015. No target is called. Have to reset. World rank 14. The Chilean. So certainly in the mix here, in with a chance. One of those more fidgety types of athletes, but it works for her. Well, no problems at all. Station three will go around to station number four. Ivan Carella and his family watching on. The man who is the boss man of Lenato in northern Italy, near Lake Garda. Wonderful part of the world. We were there just over a month ago. And he's relaxing, watching this time, not running around having to be the organizer. I mean, Javorov has that pleasure here. Here we are then in Station 4, just the one double in Skeet. Slightly different in the team competition. And we are whizzing through this. No reds on the board at all yet. It's going to come at some stage. And you suspect it might be a bit of a tight final, this one. On we go. These athletes brisk about their business. Still warm out here, you know. Not just shooting you'll find in these parts, in the hills beyond. There is mountain biking. That was where that was held for the European Games back in 2015. Right. That was what this complex was built for initially. Feeling the heat, the coaches. Three Americans in the center there, flanked by the Slovakian and Chilean coach and the Greek coach, of course. So far, nothing to sweat about, metaphorically speaking, for the Americans. Oh, and do we have our first miss? Yes, we do. It is the Chilean who is in the red. Doesn't challenge the decision. So then, round to station 5, which is a mirror image of station 3, and that means that first up, be taking one from the high house, then the low house. The reverse from the low house, rather, is the last one. That's the one that tends to be a bit tricky. But so far, just the one miss. Everyone looking pretty good. Even Kadumato Jadid will know that there is still redemption possible. It's been given as a miss. Bartikova doesn't think so. She's still looking. And a little look from the referee, the Thai referee, to the side referees, and both have given thumbs down, so it stays as a red for the woman from Slovakia. Well, the wind is just starting to get up a little bit, a bit of breeze coming through, which might make life a little more not difficult. So from that first two stations, now we're going to get a few problems. And there we go again. Well, the referee's arm all of a sudden is in action. Two misses from Katsuraki. The Americans being cheered. Smith, the first two. This is a chance to get ahead of the rest. Hits that one out of the low house really nicely, and off she strides. Job done. Now Vizzy. Great atmosphere here. The youngsters have come getting into it. And who knows, perhaps they'll come and give it a try here at the Baku Shooting Centre. And they find their next superstar. There's Lance. You cannot mistake that man comes to the United States, even without the T-shirt. So far, the Americans looking good. Well, all green for the United States athletes. T 10 out of 10 for them. Some of them will disappear off for more cartridges to our right-hand side, but Crivetto Jadid has a bit of work to do and a bit of ground to make up. Another miss, this time from the low house. She's going to stalk off and get some more, get her water, I think. So that's how it's looking after four targets. Let's move it on to 10 targets. A bit of movement, and it's advantage to the United States at the moment. Well, I suppose it's not beyond the realms of possibility we could have an all-American podium. So back round to station number three. Hardikova with that one miss from the low house on station five. Wouldn't have pleased Stefan Zemko, but she's so experienced. I'm sure she knows, especially with the number one bib number, that she has every chance still. Oh, the high house getting away from her. You could just see from her body position, little crouch, she knew that was coming. Didn't get it quickly enough. There is a bit of breeze that could just push that one from the high house down. Now, hang on, the wind's coming the other way. Push it up a little bit. Georgios Salavankiatakis is the Greek coach, watching his charge. And the Greek just behind me, making a lot of noise at that four greens. Austin Smith then being watched by Joe Buffer, which I think is one of the greatest names. He could be a film star, couldn't he? So, well, they've got three coaches in situ, isn't it, the Americans? Well, the first miss for Smith. Where is he? Yet to miss. And no target calls. One of them coming out broken. It's pretty hot. Sometimes they do stick together. No problems, good concentration. And was really quick on the one from the high house. No trouble for Vizzy, who, well, she'll keep an eye on Sam Simonton, the only one who can keep up with her at the top of the leaderboard. Jay Waldron, the man is always, if there's an American, sitting there in the coach's seat, but he's got company with his compatriots there, and that's good from Simonton. She's looking in great form. Well, it's Crivetto Jadid who has the lowest bib number, the one who has 10 targets to pull this one around, and four here would be very useful indeed. A little bit of breeze across the range. Two greens blaring out from the really bright lights we have. Other side of the range, the clock counting down from 12. And then back to the 30 you're allowed in Skeet. So at the moment, two on 14. Vizzy and Simonton looking good. Smith not far behind the other American. And then 3 on 12. It's going to be tight, this finish, as we lose our sixth place athlete. Just the double here. Reverse of what we saw in the first go around. That's a miss from Katsuraki. Oh, she'll be very annoyed about that. And that opens the door for Kuroveto Shadid. Normally, he will expect to bag these. Depends what the conditions are like, of course. But the angle a little easier. And there is another miss. Smith this time. And that's 2 in 3. Oh, dear. Vizzy has a real chance just to extend her advantage over some of the others and then put the pressure on Simonton. No target, broken target coming out. If you are new to the sport, just a reminder that these athletes, there's a microphone in front of them, they call, that you can see it there, with the referee's just going to check the targets. But also you see the yellow strip on Vizzy's jacket there, while the shotgun has to rest, part of the shotgun has to rest on there until the targets appear. It's not like trap, that's for sure. Just watch the setup. Down goes the stock of that shotgun. And no problems at all. Goes away to get away from the hubbub of the shooting position, but we'll be aware. They'll see the scoreboard. A miss from Simonton. So, Vizzy with a point lead at the moment. She has a chance, Kuroveto Shadid. She needs to hit these and the 4 from station 5, I would say. And there's a miss. Oh dear. So she is level with Katsuraki, but remember Katsuraki qualified 2nd, so it could still switch one way or the other when we're looking for our 6th place athlete. So that was after 10 targets. We've gone round another, 6 targets. Smith has dropped down to 4th place. Vizzy with the outright lead. Simonton not far behind, 2 on 14, 2 on 13. And Kuroveto Shadid is the one, because of the bib number, who is in danger at the moment of dropping out. But we've got 4 more targets. Good start from Bardakova. Don't write her off. Sun more in their eyes here than anywhere else. It's generally over your left shoulder. That's how ranges are designed. So by the time you get to finals, shouldn't be an issue. But, well, looking at the high house, you are looking in the vague direction of the sun, which is going down away to our left. Good from Bartikova, though. Lays down the marker. And then the Greeks are happy behind me. Big cheer for Katsuraki. Follows it through, but was really comfortable on that, Smith. This is the trickier one. It's the second target that tends to, as a rule, no problems at all. The one for the low house is bagged. 4 greens for her. We're back to what we were kind of in the first 2 stations of this competition. Green, green, green. Vizzy would like very much, I'm sure, to stay ahead of the pack. Perfect 20 out of 20. These are the two. Oh, how about that last one? No. After all that, commentator's curse. It's still not bad. 19 out of 20. The conditions were good. Just going to have to park that one and not worry about it too much. Simmonton with a chance to reacquaint herself with a share of the lead. Yeah. Took her time on the one from the low house. Well, whilst we were watching that, Katsuraki, the big cheer, obviously, for the 4 out of 4 means that Crevetto Jadid is the athlete who is going to take sixth place, because even if she gets up to 17, she has bib number 6, the lowest of the 6, of course. And that means she will not continue past the 20 mark. Finishes with a miss, so the bib number is academic. It is the Chilean, not quite her world championship best. That was 5th in Granada 9 years ago. She'll have to wait another year or so. Well, the Olympics are always next year, of course. You never know, do you? She was 8th in London and is always there or thereabouts. But not today, it's not hers. 6th place, but of course, let's not forget a quota place. Just a reminder of the quota place already sorted. The Americans already have their quota places. So Danka Barnikova, Emanuela Katsuraki, Francesca Clovido Chadid, and Sena Chan of Turkey, who qualified in 8th place, just behind Martina Bartomelemi of Italy. Well, she gets the 4th on offer here at the World Championships. So that's the quota places. Let's concern ourselves now with what's going to happen here in the battle to be the world champion. Barnikova, remember, just 10 targets now. We go to 30 and we lose our 5th place athlete. Katsuraki will have to just keep hitting these targets and hoping that somebody else might falter. Got a miss off the first one there, the one from the low house. A little bit distracted. I think she got some dust or something into her face. Sun continued to drop down towards the hills away on our left-hand side. Katsurakis, Graki rather, has not helped her ambitions to stay in. Another no target. Reset for Austin Smith. Sometimes in really hot finals it can be a problem, but fingers crossed, not been a terrible intrusion so far. Delay doing Smith no harm at all. Share of the lead at the moment with Barnikova. Lizzy and Simmonton may have something to say about that. A chance to make it 23 out of 24. Well, a miss from Lizzy, and again, it's being protested. It was on the first one, and our Thai referee will just pause for a moment to say to the side referee, you had a different view of that. Do you think it was good? I mean, that might have been a thumbs up from our side referee, but there's a long involved conversation going on. I'm just wondering if it was a was an issue with the targets anyway. Well, it's been overturned, as far as I can see on, yeah, there we go on our scoring as well. Just looking across at the scoreboard on, in the arena, it went back to green a fraction earlier. Well, a let off and into the lead she goes by one. Simmerton starts well, a chance now to draw level with Vizzy. Oh no, 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 missed the one from the high house. We haven't seen too many of those in this final. So it's pretty tight. 3 on 22. Just 1 on 23, and that's Vizzy. That's the view, a bird's eye view, or a, perhaps to be more accurate, a drone's eye view of our wonderful finals range. And that's the man who has made all this happen along with his team. I mean, Javorov, Secretary General. He's in a suit now. Yesterday he was in shorts and a t-shirt running around getting his, well, t-shirt, can't roll your sleeves up, but you know what I mean. Getting involved, making sure any last-minute hitches were sorted out before the finals got underway in rifle and pistol. A chance to sit and watch alongside VIPs. Partikova with a miss, an uncharacteristic miss from station four. Kataraki, well, time is running out for her. She is at a disadvantage here, should, if form is anything to go by, be fifth, but you never know. Bit of a gust of wind. I'm going to hold on to my papers. And as Vizzy takes to the shooting position.
No target.
Another no target. That's a really good lot of spectators in the stand behind us. It's really nice to see. And they are enjoying this. Young and old, experienced and not so. She had to wait a bit, didn't she, with the no targets, but there's the maintains her lead. Just the one miss. Simmerton looking to hang on to her coattails. Hand goes up. Not sure that's an issue with the microphone. Nicely done. Round to station number five we go then, and we will lose our fifth athlete at this point. At the moment, a couple of points, well, no, a point behind Partikova, but it is Kataraki, who's still in the danger zone. But she has the advantage of a number two on her back. So if she draws level with anyone underneath her in terms of bib number, Smith, Vizzy, Simmerton. And you never know. Four more targets and we'll know. First up, the Slovakian. She was at Rabat in Morocco in January, saying she was off back to home to shoot in the snow. She's been in good form, a little fist bump, double fist bump as she comes away. She'll head off to get some more cartridges, knowing that she's going to go round once again. She knows that because she knows Katsuraki cannot catch her. Katsuraki wants to post 26 and see what happens. Unlikely you'd think that she's going to be safe, but you never know. And the Greeks by me keep hoping. We will see. I can say, in effect, these... Well, Smith is going to have to... shoot 27. And she has missed one. So the pressure is on, because if it's 26 apiece, Katsuraki stays in. She's pacing around behind her here. And she's missed one. Oh, she has missed one. And that could be that for Austin Smith. Good from Vizzy. She's safe. Can she make it more than safe? She's been exceptional, hasn't she? Just the one miss so far from Vizzy. Well, Simonton needs one of these. That's why she's flashing red, because she qualified fifth. So if she is on 26, she'll be the one to take the drop. But no danger of that. One miss, so it is a squeak through. It's all getting a bit tight, isn't it? Vizzy with a couple of points cushion. Well, it's tough for Austin Smith. Little smile from her. She heads back to her seat by the coach. It went to bib number, and Katsuraki also on 26 was bib number two, Smith bib number three, and that's why qualification is so important, and the shoot-offs as well. Smith and Vizzy shot off for third and fourth, so Katsuraki and Bartikova both on 1, 2, 3. And that went to shoot-off as well. And that's why there are shoot-offs, even if the top six are fairly clear. Willie Grill will be able to tell you all this. He knows the rules inside out. The technical manager for a very long time, I think he said 20 years or so. Now the Secretary General. He's another man, like Emin, who's swapped T-shirt and shorts for a suit on a slightly more permanent basis as Secretary General. Good start from Bartikova. Quarter to six local time. It's getting a bit cooler, but the sun is still pretty fierce if you're out in it like the competitors. Katsuraki. Well, the fans are starting to believe that they might be able to do something here. A little clear of the barrels, a little walk away. Always, she gives the end of that shotgun a little wipe with the towel. And let's the Americans get on with it. Vizzy it is then, who is leading this competition and has been looking good all the way through. Another collector's item, a second miss for Dania Vizzy. So, possibility for Simonton to get back to within two.
Yeah, no. No, it's the one from the high house that does it again. Round to station five we go. It is tight. 2 points between the four athletes still involved in this competition. Who is going to miss out on a medal here at the World Championships? It's a tough, tough one to take, isn't it? At the moment, Bartikova. Certainly it's in her hands. Oh, and she misses one from what should be the easier of the three stations. A bit of breeze is blowing through. That might have something to do with it. Katsuraki can catch up here. She misses one, same one, from the high house. Oh, drama, drama, drama. And we're not talking about the place in Greece that Anna Korakaki comes from. No target. We'll go again for Daniel Vizzi. A few problems from that central station. Nicely done. Commanding lead at the moment. Simonton had a chance to get within one. Missed her last one from the high house. And has missed one here as well. And a rueful grin, but a little chat to herself. Well, it's getting interesting, isn't it? 30 targets look like that. Let's go to 36. And Katsuraki and Simonton. Well, the Americans are falling by the wayside after a really strong start. Still not all over yet, though. Marco Mori, the archetypal Italian, likes his coffee strong. And he's always got an eagle eye on the world results. That's the man making sure his targets are being converted into hits or misses. Keeping an eagle eye on the action and on the referee. Miss from Bartikova. Well, we sailed through the first two stations of this competition and then it got a little bit trickier, didn't it? Bartikova, every time she feels like she's just getting into some form, she'll hit a red. That was three in a row, green and then the red. Hit that red, of course, the last one on station four. Oh, that could be a really expensive miss from Katsuraki. Puts the pressure off Simonton a little bit because that number two bib is precious for Katsuraki. It saved her once, will it save her twice? Is he not worried about elimination? Worried about being the world champion at this rate. A couple of misses so far, but has looked very calm and collected. Oh, and there is a miss. There is a miss. So, it's, you know, no one is a country mile ahead. Now then, Simonton cannot draw level with Katsuraki. She needs to be on 35. She needs four. Big couple of targets coming up. Normally it's the one they shoot second from the low house. That's the tricky one. No, and she has missed one. And she just throws the cartridge over her shoulder
congratulates Katsuraki, who commiserates with her, but she'll be happy to be on the podium. Oh, Sam Simonton, that's going to take a little time to process, I imagine. Well, she will take fourth place. Forty targets gone. Another 10 targets. We'll know who'll take bronze. Tight between Bartikova and Katsuraki.
So we are 10 targets away from the bronze medal.
Here we go then. Buckle up, hold on to your hats. Who's going to take bronze? Who's going to be in that shoot-off for gold and silver? Well, that's better from Bartikova. Time to put the pressure on, I'd say, if you can. There's that double fist pump. Hasn't always been seen. It's been a bit of a stuttering final for her, the woman who qualified top of the pile. Keeps her nose in front of Katsuraki, but Katsuraki has just scrabbled and scrabbled. Looked like she might have to take sixth place, no. Fifth place, no. Fourth place, no. Over. Busy practicing station four. You see Katsuraki just head turned the other way to the athletes, just in her own zone. After that red at the end of her four. No problems though for Vizzy. And away we go to station number four. Less time really to get your head ready with three athletes gone. You're soon back at the shooting position. That's better. No misses that time. A little look at the coach and a fist pump. Katsuraki keeping the pressure up. Vizzy, a chance to put clear water between her and Bartikova. Nicely done. No problems at all for anybody in station four. Round we go. Station five then. Someone's going to have to leave here. It will be on bib number if needs be. No shoot-off. Well, Vizzy surely is at least a silver. Bartikova will be thinking, especially with the number one bib, I am going to get through. And Katsuraki may be saying, well, I'm always lucky at this station. Well, you make your own luck, don't you? And that'll take her through. It is Katsuraki who will take the bronze. Vizzy deigns to miss everything, and Katsuraki hits everything. You never know, stranger things have happened. Ooh, nicely done, nicely done. Well, just one hit needed to get
through to the last 10 targets, the gold and silver shootout. Aziz looks supremely good here. Yep. Katsaraki has already taken her ear defenders out. She knows the game is up, but hey, you're not going to complain at a bronze medal at the World Championships, are you? And a quota place as well.
And an Olympic quota place representing Greece, Emanuela Katsaraki.
Listen to the response she gets from this crowd as her name is announced. Quota place and a bronze. And a big hug from the coach. Well, she fought and fought, didn't she? Got past Smith and Simonton. Couldn't quite get past Bardakova. We have 10 more targets, two the difference. Vizzy has been at the top for quite some time.
As things stand, it is Bardakova with 45 hits, Vizzy with 47. Back at station three.
So then, I would say that, in my humble opinion, Bardakova probably needs to hit all of her targets as we go around this final 10, this final three stations, and just see if Vizzy has a wobble. Vizzy has not shown any sign of wanting or needing or having a wobble just yet. And that was good as the breeze got up, kept calm, got that one from the high house. Trees in the distance just bending a little bit, nothing too terrible. And there's a miss, there is a miss. And then a ooh and an ah from the crowd. High house might be the tricky one. It is a bit breezy, but well, shot it so quickly, no problems at all. One, the difference. You hear the announcer saying 10 targets hit for Bardakova. She was a bit hit and miss, literally and in form ways, but she is certainly so experienced. 38 years of age. Still in tremendous shape, still great form in this sport. And still putting the pressure on Dania Vizzy. I don't know if it is level, we go to a shoot-off. Oh, and she has missed one. And we are at 51 apiece.
Delicately poised as we make our way back to station five, which could, after four times,
well. The gold medal, but also down to four shots. It's a shoot-off in effect, really.
As they currently are, with both athletes tied on 51, we will go to a shoot-off.
So, deep breath from Bartakova. Steadies herself, is ready. Big moments in big careers are dealt with, and can Bartakova once again deal with the pressure here? She misses one. Oh, what is going on out there? Crowd are enjoying themselves, but it's a bit of a roller coaster. No problems with the last two. So it's simple, isn't it? Four hits and you're the world champion. Dania Vizzy, a little wry smile, a little shrug of the shoulders back towards her coach. Yeah, what can you do? Well, she left herself a little too much to do from early on when she was missing. And there's a miss. And straight away, Bardakova goes over to get some more ammunition. But first of all, Vizzy has to hit these two. What drama. Vizzy takes her time. She hits both of them. And we are level and we'll go to a shoot-off.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, after 60 targets, we have two athletes remaining, Bartakova and Vizzy, both
well,
tied on a 54.
This is drama.
Which means we go to a
shoot-off. Right into station three we go. And there are a few Americans shouting out, go down yet. Not the coaches, obviously. The three coaches, American coaches in the middle. Yeah, time to stroke your goatee and keep your fingers crossed, not necessarily at the same time. Well, athletes generally would say advantage to go first, but only if you can hit two. I'll just hit pairs. I'll do the reverse if needs be. Let's see who's got what it takes to be world champion. Bardakova was out of the races early on, but she put a really good run together. Two greens from the American. On we go. No one's leaving just yet. Sun still beating down over their shoulders. Long shadows now. Oh, and there is the miss. Bartakova blinks first. Well, there's a lot of noise behind me. Lizzie will be trying to blank that all out and just concentrate on this reverse. Remember, the tricky one from the high house is not a done deal. There you go. This time missing the one from the low house. Well, they're giving us our money's worth. Station four. The pressure must be immense on these two athletes. Everyone has their eyes on them now. Oh, and that doesn't help either. There's a no target, broken target coming, limping out of the high house. Now, Thai referee steps in. And like most Thais I know, he's doing it with a smile on her face. Nicely done by Bartakova. So, pressure on Vizzy. Now the reverse. Keep your head clear. Rehearse it in your mind. When you are ready, step up. There is 10 seconds on the clock. Took her time on the second one. Not a problem for her. Is this shoot-off going deep? Well, it's certainly going round to station five. What a start to our shotgun part of the World Championships here in Baku. Two greens for Bardakova. Vizzy has the pressure on her shoulders now. And doesn't miss. Now to the reverse. Nine apiece. Just the one miss from them. But crucially at the same time. The same station, same pair. Just the one fist bump this time. Must be feeling the pressure. Well, she was worried about going out from time to time. The Slovakian who qualified top is fighting hard. Vizzy, who was top of the ranking for so long, has missed one, has missed one. And down onto the floor goes Bartakova, who can't quite believe it. She is the world champion. And Vizzy, you have to feel for the American because, well, she was top for so long, but it is silver for her and she has great sportsmanship. Claps her opponent in what was a fantastic event. And Bartakova, it went deep, 11-10 the shoot-off. And the Slovakian, who qualified first, has taken the title here. And Vizzy it is, who has to settle for silver. Well, three Americans out of the six in the final, and not one of them can make it to the gold medal. Goodness me, what a wonderful competition that was. And you can see all the cartridges strewn around the shooting positions. It's been a long, old day. It's been a very, very entertaining one. Those are the three who will be on the podium. And I don't think when Dania Bartakova says she's having a good day, she can imagine this. Emanuela Katsouraki of Greece takes the bronze. Dania Vissi of United States, the silver. And the world champion is Danka Bartakova of Slovakia.
United States of America, Dania Vissi.
Well, did see Danka Bartakova, I mentioned earlier, in the main indoor complex, just taking a break. And I said, I had no idea. I said, how's it going? She said, that's okay. Well, she topped qualification and she dug in and fought herself to the top of the pile and is the world champion here in Baku. We will hear shortly from her and the other medalist. Jamie will be talking to them. That is next, so don't go anywhere.
I'm with the gold medalist from the Skeet women's event here at the ISSF World Championship Baku 2023, Danka Bartikova. Thanks for finding the energy to come and talk to us after what was a pretty epic shoot-off, right? 11:10.
Well, yes, it was so exhausting, and honestly, I was so, I excited after all the shoot-off and after the final, because I had a struggle. There were some targets that I really did struggle. And at the end of the day, it was so nerve-wracking that I'm really happy it ended up well for me.
Yeah, you pulled through, you kept on pushing. What's going through your mind when you're in a shoot-off situation like that, up against Dania Vizi, who was shooting so well throughout the final?
She was indeed shooting very well. All the finalists were extremely great today. I have to give them a huge compliment, because it was not easy to go against three Americans, Panchi and Emma, all of them outstanding shooters. So I knew it was going to be hard. For me, it was basically all about concentrating on my targets and just keeping up the speed. Sometimes I had to change something, the rhythm, because the targets were not easy. It was a little bit windy, small breeze, which made the targets fly strangely. So it was all about the focus on what I have to do and how I want to do that.
And you did it. You pulled through 11:10, like we said, on the shoot-off there. And finally, let's just point out the fact that it's a triple whammy: gold medal, world champion, and a quota place for Slovakia.
Yeah, it's a dream come true. For me, this year I'm struggling a little bit. Last year I was one behind the quota at the European Championships. It was just this close. At the World Championship last year, it was again this close. So it was a little bit, I was nervous. I honestly were nervous. So for me, it's a dreamy day. I'm really excited about how it ended, and I have to say, it took me 25 years to get this title. So yes, finally it's done.
Well, you got it now. Go and enjoy it. Thank you very much, Danka Bartikova, gold medalist in the women's skeet event. And we have more interviews coming up. I'm with our silver medalist now from the women's skeet event here at the ISSF World Championship Baku 2023. Dania Vizi, thank you for joining us. It went all the way to a shoot-off, 11:10. How are you feeling right now?
Very excited. Obviously, I'm disappointed with my last pass of the final, having to get it to a shoot-off, but I'm happy with the result. I mean, you can't be unhappy going home with a silver medal at the World Championships.
No, it's pretty good, isn't it? World Championship silver. And it was a very competitive final. You were leading the way for a long time, but it was a competitive field, wasn't it?
Very competitive field. I mean, this is the best in the world. One of the biggest world championships, I heard, that we've ever had. So to be out there with all those amazing athletes is really, really awesome.
It's pretty awesome. And silver medal again, pretty awesome. So thank you, Dania Vizi. Take care. And we've got more to come, so don't go anywhere. More interviews and the victory ceremony coming up live as well. I'm now with Emanuela Katsaraki of Greece, who took bronze today in the women's skeet event. Let's talk about that bronze medal first. This is your first World Championship medal, I believe.
Yes, this was my first World Championship final. So yes, it's my first medal.
And how did it feel for you? How can you compare it to other finals you've appeared in?
Honestly, it didn't feel really different. We've always been competing with the best of the best. So I've had a little bit of practice, so it's been a great experience for me. But honestly, didn't feel any different.
And extra special because you secured a quota place for Greece.
Yes, even before the final, I secured the quota, which is a super special thing for me, and I'm very grateful for it.
Yeah, well, enjoy it and enjoy your bronze medal. We'll see you at the victory ceremony on the podiums very soon. So thank you to Emanuela Katsaraki of Greece, who took bronze in the skeet women's event.
Yes, it is.
Welcome back to the ISSF World Championship here in Baku in the year 2023. The women's skeet event is over. We're bringing you more interviews this time from Chile. It is Francisca who secured a quota place today. First of all, how are you feeling about that?
Yes, I did. Oh, I'm so happy. Of course, one of the biggest dreams of any athlete, shooter, is being Olympic. This is will be my fourth time, and I'm so happy to already have the quota, already qualify. I'm so happy to be already in Paris.
So it's a relief for you, yeah.
Yes, you're right. It's a relief. Now we have the Pan American Games in my country, in Chile, in Santiago. So now I'm focused on that podium.
Yeah. Okay. But first, let's just talk about the World Championship here. How's the experience been for you? The range here in Baku, the conditions, a little bit of wind during the final there, and also very hot generally, hasn't it?
Yes, very, very hot weather and also windy during the competition and also during the finals. I'm so happy with my qualification score. I shot a very strong 121. I also have to make a shoot-off to enter to the final, so it wasn't easy to be in this final, to be in the first six. So it had been a great competition. I broke my wrist 3 months ago, so... it's nice to come back and go avanti of all of this.
Yeah, to come back and be very competitive as well.
Yes, a very high level. You know how you say this is the world championship in all events. So you have this eat for years. So it's nice. It's nice to be in the top six.
In the mix, yep. Sixth place here at the World Championship and a quota place for Chile. So enjoy that moment and enjoy the Pan American Games at home as well. And thank you for talking to me.
Thank you. Bye.
You're welcome. So that is Francisco Crovetto Jadid, who has secured a quota place for Chile for the Paris 2024 Olympic Games here at the ISSF World Championship 2023. And we've got lots more to come, so stay tuned.